Hey, Kurt, who's listening in Janesville, Wisconsin on Sirius XM Radio 130. Kurt, how are you? Thanks for calling in.
I'm fine, thank you. And by the way, my cousin is Pierre Palat, who played for the Blackhawks.
Sorry, your audio is breaking up a little bit. What's his name?
Pierre Palat.
Oh, my goodness, Pierre Palat. Wow, reaching back. I remember reading about him in hockey history books.
Anyway, my question is, how did chivalry pertain to the Crusades?
Sure, Kurt. Yeah, thanks for the question. How does chivalry pertain to the Crusades? Well, you know, obviously those who participated greatly in the Crusades were men from the warrior class, you know, warriors. And there were actually others that went on crusade as well, you know, including women and non-combatants and things like that. But yeah, definitely the desire to participate in this holy undertaking of the armed pilgrimage of what they called the passagia or the passage. It was this pilgrimage to the Holy Land to help liberate the Church of the Holy Sepulchre from the hands of Islam was motivated in many ways by this desire among the warrior class to serve the church, which was an element of chivalry, to serve those in need, which obviously is a big part of chivalry as well, to serve, you know, men and, or to women and children who might be under attack and defenseless. And that's what they saw what they were doing and what the Pope actually urged them to do. That there were reports coming out in time of the First Crusade with the Seljuk Turks and other Muslim entities that were attacking indigenous Christians in the Holy Land, in Jerusalem in particular. And so that would have motivated greatly these men to go on. And you'll see it in the writings of popes in later crusades, with Eugenius III, for example, in the Second Crusade, where he calls upon the kind of the manliness, if you will, of the French warrior class to go on crusade, to respond to his call to help the Christians in the Holy Land. So that played a very big part of it and was a prime motivator, because that's what these men were steeped in. You know, they from an early age been raised to be warriors, to hone their military skills, and again to put them at the use of those who were in most need.
Okay, hopefully, Kurt, that answers your question about that. All right.
It does. Thank you.
Okay, thanks, Kurt. Appreciate that.
Thanks. Thank you, Kurt.